In this video, we're gonna talk about cross anatomical features of the stomach. Now, this is the abdominal part of the esophagus, which is intraperitoneal. But the rest of the esophagus, the cervical and thoracic parts of the esophagus, has no peritoneal relation or the peritoneal coverage. It is covered by the connective tissue and it is adhered to the surrounding structures by the connective tissue. And the esophagus passes through the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm to enter the abdominal cavity. And part of the esophagus, that part of the stomach where the stomach receives the esophagus is called the cardia of the stomach. Here there is the cardiac incisor. Now if we, let's open this one, look at cardiac incisor is here. If we take a horizontal line from the cardiac incisor, the part of the stomach above this horizontal line is the fundus of the stomach. And if we follow the left margin of the esophagus, it becomes the crater curvature of the stomach. This is the crater curvature of the stomach. The right margin of the esophagus becomes the lesser curvature of the stomach. Lesser omentum attaches to the lesser curvature of the stomach. Crater omentum attaches to the crater curvature of the stomach. Crater curvature of the stomach is 45 times longer than the lesser curvature of the stomach. Around the esophagus, anterior to the esophagus, we have the anterior vecal trunk. Posterior to the esophagus, we have the posterior vecal trunk. Anterior vecal trunk is formed by the left vecal nerve, and posterior vecal trunk is formed by the right vagus nerve. And stomach is an intraperitoneal organ, completely covered by peritoneum. Along the lesser curvature of the stomach, we have two arteries. This is the left gastric artery, a branch to the celiac trunk. And this is the right gastric artery. This is a branch to the proper hepatic artery. Commonly, this is a branch to the proper hepatic artery. Right and left gastric arteries run along the lesser curvature of the stomach between the layers of the lesser omentum, and they anastomize end to end. Let's look at the greater curvature of the stomach. Here, on the left side of the greater curvature, we have the left gastro-omental artery. This is a branch to the splenic artery. And this one here is the right gastro-omental artery. This is a branch to the, or terminal branch to the gastroduodenal artery. And this right and left gastro-omental arteries run along the greater curvature of the stomach between the layers of the greater omentum, and they anastomize end to end. Now, let's review the parts of the stomach. Here is the cardia of the stomach, where the esophagus enters the stomach. This part is the fundus of the stomach. You draw a horizontal line from the cardiac notch to part of the stomach above this horizontal line is the fundus of the stomach. Here is the along the lesser curvature, there is an angular notch. If you draw a line from this angular notch, right to the, this line from starting from the angular notch is the pyloric part of the stomach. Pyloric part of the stomach. Now this part is the pyloric antrum. Here is the pyloric canal, and this ends up with the pylorus. Here is the pylorus. Now let's look at the musculature of the stomach. Well, the musculature that we have around the esophagus also continue to be present around the stomach. So, we have the outer longitudinal muscle layer, and then you have the outer longitudinal muscle layer, circular muscle layer, and oblique muscle fibers, which are found only around the corpus of the stomach. I haven't described to you the corpus or the body of the stomach. Let's describe it. So the part of the stomach between the fundus and the pylorus, pyloric part, is the body of the stomach, which is the largest part of the stomach. Here is again the pylorus. Now let's open the stomach and see what we have inside the stomach. Well, here is the entrance to the stomach. Here is the cardiac ostium. Here is the exit of the stomach. This is the pyloric ostium. Pyloric ostium. Around the pyloric ostium, there is a sphincter. This is called pyloric sphincter, which is formed by the circular muscle layer of the stomach. And around the entrance of the esophagus to the stomach, there is also another sphincter. This is called lower esophageal sphincter. Lower esophageal sphincter. Well, lower esophageal sphincter is a more physiological sphincter than anatomical sphincter. But this is a very important sphincter. If this doesn't work well, or if it relaxes, then content of the stomach may reflux to the esophagus and can hurt, can damage the mucosa of the esophagus. It's called the reflux. Okay, inside the stomach, the musculature of the stomach forms elevations or folds inside the stomach. These are called gastric folds or the ruga. Gastric folds or the ruga. Okay, along the lesser curvature of the stomach, along the lesser curvature of the stomach, we do not have gastric folds. So this part is called gastric canal. Especially during swallowing, this gastric canal becomes more apparent. And gastric canal, or the street of the Valdeir, or the Valdeir's street, is the shortest distance between the entrance and exit of the stomach. And the fluids we drink, or the fluids part of the foods we take in, does not get in the body of the stomach. The fluids run through the lesser curvature of the stomach and enter the duodenum. Okay, so the parasympathetic innervation to the stomach comes with the vagus. Remember, vagal nerve supplies parasympathetic innervation down to distal one-third of the transverse colon. And the sympathetic innervation to the stomach comes through the thoracic greater splanchnic nerve arising from the spinal cord segments T5 through T9.